Ask Reddit. Guy drops a glove in a deep fryer. Sticks his entire hand in it before realizing it's on and set to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. My current job is a lab technician at a major university. And we had a new guy unplug the small minus 80 degrees Celsius freezer full of recombinant DNA because he wanted to charge his phone. A guy I worked with was measuring high voltages and let the HT probe touch the metal chassis of the instrument, which he also had his other hand resting on. We heard the zap from the other end of the lab. A co-worker received a promotion and a large raise. They were told they should thank the CEO as he initiated the entire promotion. My co-worker went on a rant about not asking for any of it, so he's not thanking anyone. And it escalated from there. By the end of the day, he was fired. My co-worker actually turned a promotion into a termination. I work at a call center. I reviewed a call where the guy thought the phone was muted and called the customer a stupid ass moth affair. The customer called him out and he tried to backpedal and make up some story. He was fired shortly after. One of my co-workers at a grocery store accidentally locked the only master key set into the security office. Then attempted to break the door down with a claw hammer before anyone could find out. 10 minutes of furious attacking only succeeded in attracting the attention of everyone in the store. Breaking off the handle and bending the entire lock. Making it inoperable by the locksmith brought in later. I used to work at Popeyes. This fried chicken chain. It sucked and I eventually quit. A week after I quit, the night crew decided they didn't feel like putting the boxes away from a truck shipment. Someone could deal with it next day. Few days later. And several reports of food poisoning later. They got in a load of trouble. Boxes were full of raw chicken. So glad I quit. What's the most spectacular way you've seen someone F up at work? A grad student was invited into a professor's office for a meeting and was left alone for a moment. There was a pile of cumulative exams on the professor's desk that had just been graded. These are subject exams for grad students. Wickedly difficult. And you need to pass 4 to continue in the program. This jackass decided he'd take a look at the stack of exams. Then upon finding that some of his fellow students did poorly, he took pictures of their grades so he could use them to ridicule them and pass the results around the department. This was a big deal because numerical grades aren't ever given out for these exams. Only pass fail. And also it's a pretty big FERPA violation to distribute others' personal academic information like that. He was found out almost as soon as he sent the pics around and was dismissed and forbidden from campus immediately. Someone else had to pack up his desk because they were that serious about him never setting foot in the building again. Worked in a single-story cinder block office with parking spaces out front. There was a big window that overlooked the parking lot. We had an older engineer, early 70s, that worked there. He pulled up one morning in his parking spot and must have gotten the brakes and the gas confused. He drove the car right through the window, taking out some of the wall with it. I can still remember seeing him gripping the steering window with this terrified look in his eyes while he kept slamming on the gas. The car must have gotten stuck on something because it would just lurch forward and the engine would rev. Luckily he didn't kill anyone. He retired soon after that. A substitute came into work completely drunk once. This job started at 8. And he drove there drunk. I get that junior high is stressful. But drink afterward. I'm a welfare caseworker. A few months ago I got a call from a client wondering what was going on with her case. Read the case comments and found that one of my more intellectual co-workers shut down this case and assessed a 5-year overpayment on this client for her cash aid, basically saying that all the aid she had ever received was fraudulent and she needed to pay it all back. Her reasoning? There was a glitch in the system that made this woman's child show as a resident in a different county. Rather than following established protocol and calling this woman, or ordering a fraud investigation from our literal unit of full-time investigators, or anything else that would make sense, she went out of her way to make this woman's life hard. For the record, I called the other county and the worker I spoke with confirmed that the child was no longer a resident. His father had reported to them that the family was moving to our county 5 years ago, and they'd been trying, unsuccessfully, to update his county residence ever since. Because I caught the phone call, I had to unf the case and close out the overpayment. I work at a group home for people with mental and physical disabilities. Most of the residents cannot walk or even stand on their own, so staff will help them stand or hold onto them while they walk so they don't fall over. Well, I had one co-worker that was stupid for multiple reasons, but this one takes the cake. She helped one of the residents stand up to use the restroom. Had her put her hands on the handlebar attached to the bathroom, similar to bathroom stall, and left to get things that the resident needed to take a shower. She left her standing there alone for a solid 3 or 4 minutes. Of course the resident fell and hit her head pretty good. Had to go to the hospital and get stitches. She ended up being fine afterwards. How on earth my co-worker wasn't fired is completely beyond me. Someone was using a scissor lift to paint the inside wall of our warehouse. This warehouse area had in the past contained a small office which according to code required a sprinkler head inside the office. There was a long pipe extending down from the ceiling that now just had a sprinkler head pointed at the ground considering the office had been removed. The operator of the scissor lift did not realize this pipe was here and ran into it with the scissor lift. The pipe broke off in spectacular fashion, spewing disgusting 30-year-old black water all over the warehouse for an hour before anyone came in to help them considering it was the weekend. The water had pooled up so much it created a river which flowed directly into the office area. I was watching on the camera since I was at home far from the warehouse. The look on the guy's face was heartbreaking. I do remember the CEO of the company being there in his weekend attire helping clean up. He walked into the office area where the guy who broke the sprinkler was. I could see the dread on his face. Almost brought a tear to my eye when I saw the CEO give him a pat on the back and a hug. That place was full of wild stories like this. Surgeon was a notorious a-hole to colleagues but had been getting away with it for years. One day he was doing a minor surgery on a lightly sedated, mostly awake, patient and said some horrible things directly to the patient. And the patient remembered it. He contested his firing. And the hospital had to go through an arbitration process. But all the other staff in the room corroborated the patient's story and testified against him. And now he's gone. And he deserved to be gone a long time ago. Couple of years ago, we had a new supervisor directly from corporate. He got a promotion and moved from another city. He was a complete jerk. Micromanagement nightmare. Arrogant. ETC. ETC. But someone up the corporate ladder really liked the guy. So he had full support from the bosses. Then in his first month of work his company car was stolen. It was insured, so no big deal. A week later his replacement car was stolen again, and a third car 2 weeks later. Turns out the guy had a trouble with alcohol. He got really drunk and left the car open on the street and he just forget about it. He wasn't fired. He was just moved to a desk job with no company car. Someone bought $100 in lottery tickets. Then convinced my dumbest co-worker to give him a refund on the losing ones. I did not see this, but it is a well-known case in employment law. Using a forklift to lift a wheelchair-bound co-worker up to a elevated deck to attend a safety seminar. Testing an industrial microwave that had come back as damaged on site. They straight it off by turning it on and running the RF meter over it to check for leakage. The meter immediately maxed out and they shut it off. Turns out they didn't look it over first. And it had a huge hole burned through the side wall of the microwave. I work with preemies in a neonatal ICU. We get morphine in a multi-dose syringe that is good for 24 hours. We generally give doses from it every 4 hours. Every time we dose, we have to chart the amount in the electronic medical record. Calculate a safe does. Draw it up. Show it to another nurse along with the calculations. Scan it, there are a million safety checks. A nurse did exactly none of those things and gave the whole syringe to the baby. Then she ordered another and did it again in 4 hours. And then she did it again 4 hours later. The baby got way more than 3 days worth of morphine in 12 hours. He had to be put on a breathing machine. Somehow, there was a nursing shortage in Pennsylvania at the time. She did not get fired. My co-worker sold someone an auto insurance policy but forgot to check the effective date. Turns out she had pushed the start date of the policy out a month. Guy got into an accident a few days later. Cumulatively, we probably spent 10 plus hours on the phone trying to get claims to cover this guy's accident. She ended up messing up the effective date on about 10 other policies before she left. One time this complete idiot I worked with in the shipyards, a pipe welder, was torching a pipe next to lagging, which is what helps insulate Navy ships. Instead of taking 5 minutes at most to use a blade to remove said lagging, the idiot welded the pipe and torched the lagging. It doesn't burst into flames, but there was a lot of smoke, and ended up getting the ship evacuated. He got fired 2 weeks later because while his write-up was pending, he put a ladder in the middle of a passageway, which are extremely tight when you consider the heavy equipment moving through. When he was asked to move, the welder told the person asking to F off. And when you tell that to the shipyard director, well, you tend to get fired. Me. I threw all my savings to pay off my loan, thinking I'll build up an emergency fund in few months. Lost my job on the same day. Currently work for a large medical practice. Saw surveillance video of man who randomly pressed the quench button on one of our MRI machines. The button is only supposed to be pressed in emergency situations and can cost upwards of $50,000 to repair the MRI magnet. The man who did it was husband of a custodial worker and he had no clearance to be in one of our offices. The cleaning company's contract was swiftly terminated. And those two were most likely shkanned as a result. One of the cops on a base I was stationed at ran his vehicle right into the wing of a jet. He then decided to throw the light bar that had been sheared off into a random dumpster. Like it never happened. The idiot was caught immediately.